Now let us study the different essay units and their definitions also. Okay, so first one is length. Okay, length is measured in meters. The symbol is m. The definition of meter is 1 meter is the length of the path traveled by light in vacuum in 1/299792458 of a second. Okay, it is given 1983. See now, imagine that light travels in this direction here. So light travels very fast. Okay, so we take the time here for it to travel. So 1/299792458. Okay, of a second. Okay, that means in this amount of fraction of second, how much distance the light travels? That we say take it as 1 meter. Okay, let me show it to you. Okay, so in this time interval, that is 1/299792458 of a second. Okay, you can see it now. Okay, yes. So in this time interval, how much distance light travels? That is called as 1 meter. Okay, that is definition of 1 meter. Next, let's go to the other definitions. The second one is mass. Mass measured in kilogram. Symbol is kg. 1 kilogram is the mass of prototype cylinder of platinum iridium alloy, whose height is equal to its diameter. Preserved at the International Bureau of Weights and Measures at Sèvres near Paris, France. It was given in 1901. So let's see what does it mean. Okay, so there is a cylinder. Okay, its height is equal to its diameter, like this way. Okay, so this cylinder is made up of an alloy called as platinum and iridium. Okay, it's an alloy. Okay, alloy means we melt two metals and mix them. Okay, so this one, they say it is, its weight is 1, or mass is 1 kilogram. So mass as unit is kilogram. Okay, so the next one is time. Time is measured in seconds. Okay, second. Symbol is S. 1 second is the duration of 9192631770 periods of radiation corresponding to the radiation transition between the two hyperfine levels of the ground state of cesium-133 atom. It was given in 1967. Okay, let's see what does it mean. See, a cesium atom will have two levels there, or many levels there. Okay, so this is one level of the electrons. Okay, we know that in outermost orbit there will be electrons. So when you give energy, the electron will go upwards to another level. Okay, we call this as energy levels there. Energy levels. Okay, so when this electron goes to this energy level, it will also try to come back now. While coming back, it will give out the energy. Okay, that energy it gives out will be in this frequency saying, okay, how many times this wave comes out, it's a microwave, it comes out in 9192631 and then 770 okay, hertz. So this amount of waves is given out, like a radio wave or cell phone wave, it's given out. They will measure that and then they will say it is 1 second. So this happens in a cesium atom. Okay, so cesium is used in atomic clocks. Okay, so this is very much useful also. Okay, maybe we use in GPS also. We use this. GPS satellites have the cesium atomic clock in them. The next definition is about electric current. Electric current is measured in amperes. The symbol is capital A. So let's see definition now. 1 ampere is the constant current which when maintained in each of the two straight parallel conductors of infinite length and negligible cross-section held 1 meter apart in vacuum shall produce a force per unit length of 2×10⁻¹ newton per meter between them. Okay, let's see what does it mean. So let us take two wires there and we send a current there. Okay, current of 1, i current is equal to 1 ampere we sending. When you send this, what happens? This wire will go this way. Okay, there will be a force there. Okay, the force is saying it is 2×10⁻¹ newtons per meter. For every meter, it will give a repulsive force of this amount. Okay, you can see it now better. So the force will be 2×10⁻¹ newton per meter. Okay, so for every meter, the repulsive force will be this amount. So that's the definition of 1 ampere. Next, we take temperature. Temperature is measured in Kelvin. Okay, Kelvin symbol is capital K. 1 Kelvin is a fraction 1/273.16 of the thermodynamic temperature of the triple point of water. Okay, so let's see what does it mean now. So they say that 1 Kelvin is a fraction. Okay, the fraction will be 1 by 273.16 273.16 okay of the thermodynamic triple temperature of the triple point of water. So what does the triple point of water means? See, now we'll draw a graph there, okay, between all the three states of matter. Okay, so water exists in three forms: solid, liquid and gas. So below this we can say water exists as solid, okay, this will be liquid and this will be a gas. So at this point, you see, at one temperature, water will exist in three forms. It will be in three forms, that is solid, liquid and gas. This is called as a triple point of water. Okay, it's called as triple point. That means the water will be existing in three cases also, that is solid, liquid and gas. Okay, so you can see now. So this will be the triple point of water, means the water exists in three forms, solid, liquid and gas. Okay, so that is called as triple point of water. And we take a fraction of that, that will give us a 1 Kelvin. Okay, next one is amount of substance that is measured in moles. The symbol is MOL. 1 mole is amount of substance which contains as many elementary entities as there are atoms in 0.012 kilogram of pure carbon 12 atom. Okay, so let's see this now. I think in 10th you learnt about the concept of Avogadro number. Okay, so Avogadro number, that is 6.022 into 10 power 23. Okay, it can be atoms or molecules or any other species here. Okay, so imagine that we take a tumbler of water. Okay, and then in this tumbler of water, we can find how many water molecules are there with help of this concept here. Okay, so that is called as 1 mole. Okay, so this number is Avogadro number. It's also called as 1 mole. Okay, it is a number of atoms in 0.012 kilogram of carbon 12 atom. Okay, you can see it now. So this amount of this Avogadro number of molecules will be in 0.012, okay, 12 kilogram of carbon 12 atom. So that will contain this Avogadro number of atoms. So that is called as 1 mole. Now we'll go to the last definition here, that is luminous intensity. It is given candela. Okay, symbol is CD. 1 candela is the luminous intensity in a given direction of a source that emits monochromatic radiation of frequency 5.4 into 10 power 14 hertz and that has a radiant intensity of 1 by 683 watt per steradian in the direction. Let's see what does it mean. So let us now see what does candela mean. Okay, so they have a source there, okay, a light source which will give out light there. It's like a torch, okay, or something. It gives out light, okay, and then it emits monochromatic radiation. They're saying monochromatic radiation. Monochromatic radiation means the light of a single color. Okay, so mono means single and chroma means color. Okay, and it has a frequency. This is the frequency of that will be, you know, nu is equal to 5.4 into 10 power 14 hertz. This will be its frequency. Okay, that's the frequency of this light source. That is color it gives. And then it has intensity. They say it is 1 by 683 watts per steradian. Okay, so this is we'll see what is it meant by watt and what's steradian coming class. Okay, so this kind of substance or this source will give out 1 candela. So by using this we can measure what's meant by candela.